Hello and welcome to this video where I talk about the best explainer software that you can access just in a web browser. I've been waiting ages for this and now it's finally here. I'm using Videoscribe, and for some time Videoscribe wasn't very good on the web. I'm going to put a screenshot here of the video I made. It wasn't very good, but I think now it's actually a really good contender, and having used it for a couple of projects, I actually think Videoscribe on the web is maybe the best explainer video software you can get that's web-based. So the first thing you can do is you can pick from a template, and you can see already there's some social media post ones here, or you can create your own. We're going to just have a quick look at this Instagram post template here, and we're going to use this one to create a new project. So as we can see here, we've got graphs, and graphs is something that Videoscribe does very well. This isn't an actual graph, this is just a shape. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the whole project. So we get quite a good preview, which is really good. And I'm going to stop it there. I'm not going to go for the whole 20 seconds. Now, one thing people always ask is, what's the maximum duration? Well, down here I can see that each video can go up to 15 minutes. You can have 25 scenes and you can have 150 elements. So if you were going to ask that, I've already answered it. I'm going to go back to home because I'm going to create my own project. So when we create a project, we can pick between our normal landscape, our square and our vertical, which is really good to see. And I'm just going to call this one demo. I want to create a landscape one. And we land in this really simple but really quite effective browser where we've got scenes down the side, and we can add a scene. We can move the scenes around if we want to, and we can change the background color. We can have a gradient, white or custom, and we can even change the way scenes transition. So I quite like this drag on scene, and we can have the direction, and we can have a duration, and we can pick our hand type. So I'm quite happy with the hand I've already got. So I've just gone and I've uploaded an image of Doodly on one slide and an image of DoodleMaker on the other, because I think it's really important to talk about those and put some context into this. I'm going to put this in the middle. I'm going to make it really big, like so, and I'm going to do exactly the same here. And you can see that it's really quite easy to move things about. There's no aligning tools, but that's not the end of the world. We can rotate here if we want to. Now we've got our transitions between the slides. So I'm going to play this and I'm going to talk about why I've included Doodly and DoodleMaker. So Doodly is by far the biggest explainer video software. It's the best, but you have to have a PC or a Mac. You can't use it on a Chromebook, you can't use this on mobile, and you can't use it in a browser. And you also need to have a Voomly application and account. I've done many reviews and videos on Doodly, and you can see my Doodly review here. While it is a good price, maybe it's not for everyone because there isn't a web compatible version. If we look at DoodleMaker, this is solely for the web, and it came out a few years ago, and it will work on a Chromebook and it'll work in any browser, but it does have some downsides. But one of its strengths that people really like in DoodleMaker is it has TTS voices, which you don't get here in this software. I personally think the Videoscribe online version is so much better than DoodleMaker, so that's why I wanted to talk about them. Text is really good. All we do is we click on the text, and I'm struggling here because I've got two things overlapping. So all we do is we double click and we type our text in. So I'm going to put online only. I might want to pick a more favorable font for writing, like Patrick Hand, and I might want to make it bigger. And what I can do here is I can just put that on top. And if I right click it, I get some options here. But I think that's absolutely fine there. And if I go to animation, and this applies to everything, I can change the animation type. So I can have it hand drawn, pen drawn. It can draw without a hand. It can fade in. It can move. It can be dragged in. It can bounce. I can pick my hand. I can pick my duration. I can also do some emphasizing of it. So let's play from the current elements. So here's our Doodle Maker, and online only gets drawn in, and then it bounces up and down for 3 seconds. So that's really good. And we can also have an exit animation as well. So I could have it just disappear and we pause before the next element. Down here are your assets, and your assets, they're in order, and you can just move those around. It's really easy. You can also switch to timeline mode if you want to be more precise, but I think this just assets view is absolutely fine. Now, if I go to images, I can upload my own, which you've already seen, or I've got quite an extensive set of images here and I can search for them, which is really useful. So if I make explainer videos, I might want to search for a business person. So as soon as I start typing, it starts to filter, which is really good. So we might find that there aren't any suitable business people, but we might find that this is a suitable business person. So if I click here, this person comes over here and they're going to be the third to go on. Now, if I don't like that setup, I can click on edit and I can change their appearance. So this is really good because this is an included asset. So I might find I don't like the highlight, so I want a nice red highlight, and I might find I don't really want a black line. I want a deep red line. Not that that looks particularly good, that looks better. So I can go and edit those things. I can delete it. I can do some cropping, replacing, flipping, all those standard things you would think you can get. Now with shapes, we've got just standard shapes. They're not that good, the shapes. I can pick a color, I can pick a gradient. I can't put an outline around it. They're just shapes. I can move them this way and that, which is quite useful. Now in the standard version, the desktop version, you get bar graphs and things, and you do get it in this version, but I suspect you can't start to define values. So in the desktop version, I can define values on my charts, which is really useful, but I can't do it here. So I'm stuck with this shape, but I can't do anything about that. So now if we want to share it, it tells us that we can create a preview link, and if we create a preview link, people can see it without downloading it, or we can download it as a video or a GIF. Now we are limited to 15 downloads per day. I can't see myself going over that, and it's recommending that I use the preview button if I'm not sure, rather than making the video and downloading it. And again, we've got MP4 format or GIF format if we want that as well. I think Videoscribe Online is really good. It's really easy to use, and it only has a few features missing from the desktop version. But, and there is a big but, and that but is the pricing, because you cannot buy this outright. You have to pay a license of either £35 a month or £155 per year, which is the much cheaper option. There is a code that pops up occasionally that says sale 10, that gives you another 10% off, and you can have a 7-day free trial. Now in the free trial, and if you subscribe to it, whether monthly or yearly, you get access to both the desktop version, which I reviewed before, and the online version. You get access to both of them. So the only downside to this is that it is more expensive. It's a lot more expensive than Doodly. It's a lot more expensive than DoodleMaker, but it is, as far as I can see, the best explainer software that can run in a web browser. Thank you ever so much. Goodbye.